Welcome back to Let's Play Torment, Tides of Numenera. I'm the RPG chick, as always. We need to find a mall that leads to the Bloom's heart. I spoke to Dragogen, who reluctantly admitted that he doesn't know the way to reach the Bloom's heart. Chrysler said that the mall leading to the heart can only be seen if it wants to be. He suggested asking someone at the Shrine of Chilla for help. And this bothers me that this thing is still here, because we've already given him the cortex in return for us keeping the magmatic annulet. So this should be wiped off here now. But what are you gonna do?
As you wish.
As you wish. I wonder if Sundermuns have anything to say about it though. I wonder if they have anything to say, because I gave away the location of the girl that he loved. Oh, they sell things, right? Let's see if they have anything. They have a Bloom Flesh armor. See, again, I don't want my esoteric attacks decreased, especially. I really not appreciate the might and speed going down either, so screw that. This is a... What am I using? I'm using a transdimensional scalpel. That's a Bloom Bone Shard, which is not as powerful, I guess. For... Actually, it does more damage because it's got four transdimensional... No, three... Sorry. I'm looking at mine. I'm used to them being on the other side. The left side should be mine. The right side should be what I'm buying. Just seems right that way. Three physical damage and four chemical damage. So you got seven damage altogether instead of four. And then the damage per effort applied and max are the same. Critical hits confer controlled for one round. Meanwhile, here in critical hits, we get phased. I'm gonna keep the one I have. This is a cipher. We have enough ciphers. I mean, maybe I could take one more. I think we could, Tiber could handle it. But really, we need to pick up as well. We'll buy the Fleetfoot Moss. We still have so much money. Chirurgeon. No, Chirurgeon Sphere is what we have. Metabolism Flesh Bud. Plus one speed, edge, plus one damage per effort applied. Negative two speed pool. I'm gonna leave that. Yeah, there's not a lot of great stuff here. This is his son here. Oh, hypothetically, why would I ask that? Isn't it strange to be apprenticed to your older self? So he told you, huh? At first I thought the old man was just telling tall tales, but I believe him now. He knew too much about me to be anybody but my older self. And how do you feel about it? Knowing you're going to be swallowed by a maw and end up in another world. It terrified me for a while, but now I think it's great. I mean, not only do I know I'm going to have an amazing adventure, I know for sure I'm going to live through it just fine. I can see what's going to happen to me in the future. I know my fate, and that's incredibly comforting. As for the apprenticeship, well, who could teach me better than myself? He thinks, I wish the old man would tell me more. Will I learn to fight? Meet a girl? I wish to know. Oh, I want to know. What would happen, this is going to be blue tide, maybe red as well. What would happen if, hypothetically, of course, I were to kill you? Blue tide, small amount. Kill me? He thinks, the old man didn't tell me about this. Would the older version of you just disappear? Would this whole shop cease to exist? Or would it be impossible to do? I don't know. I've never thought about it before. He backs away. Why would you even ask something like that? He thinks, no, I'll be okay, right? Because the old man is still here? This probably happened to him already. We have actually an option to attack. Oh my god, that's so evil, I wouldn't do that. Just curious, don't worry, I wouldn't actually do it. Right, I knew that. He swallows hard and edges further away from you. He thinks, ha, I knew it'd be okay. I knew it. Maybe I'm not ready for this adventure after all. I just want to ask him about himself. Yeah, that's it. Okay. Oh, walks without fear. I want to ask him. Just want to see if they what they have to say about the heart of the moon, if anything. Let's just review this. A vast beating heart. Its viscera. Stood in open maws and looked across alien landscapes. While crystal fields glitter under distant stars. We've seen that. Crystal fields. He doesn't remember. At least I no longer remember having been anywhere but my protective host.
I'm ready.
Okay, I just want to talk to Ioxu here. See if he might have anything new to say or anything about the Bloom's heart. The Vargellan's manner is noticeably deferential. You return. What is your pleasure? Oh, that's right, he sells stuff. I'm forgetting about all the people who sell things, guys. Sorry. Oh, he did? You promised to modify this scalpel. Improved. Nice. Well, I'm glad I didn't, well, I wouldn't have sold it in any case. I would have held on to it. He holds out his hand without looking you in the eye. He keeps his eyes focused elsewhere until you place the scalpel in his palm. He sets it on his bench, and his fingers fly between his tools and the blade. The process takes only a few moments, and when he has finished, he extends his arm to the side and waits for you to take it from his palm. When you do, he returns to his notes. His sullen air is almost infectious. He didn't want to do it, huh? Alright, so how do we improve? We just looked at this thing. Oh, nice. Now we have 9 transdimensional damage, as opposed to, I think it was 4? And now we can get to a max of plus 18 instead of 15 for the max effort applied. Cut through dimensions. Minus 5 resistance on critical hits. That's on a hit. And critical hits gain phased. Carries all damage to transdimensional. Plus 30% evasion, plus 3 resistance. But transdimensional damage dealt to this character is 100%, or plus 100%. Does that mean like double damage? That would stink. Okay. That's awesome, as long as we don't fight transdimensional things. Which we fought something like that before, those weird corpse things that we found in the buried crossroads of the Fallen God. Not the Fallen God, the Changing God. How do you turn off the field generator in the middle of the room? The underside, close to me. A switch covered in supple material When thrown, deactivates the device, but I beg, do not do this. Its strength is what keeps the bloom from devouring me. All that I have accomplished in life will be for naught, my work unfinished, all this knowledge lost. I do not wish to bandy words with you. Okay, he's got this stuff. Okay, that's a cipher, just gives you... We've looked at this stuff before, I'm pretty sure. Unless it's new, in which case, I don't remember in any case. It looks familiar. This is a heavy ranged weapon. Kalish Jeez is the only one among us who can use ranged weapons, or who does use ranged weapons, and she can't use heavy, so never mind for this. Spirit Shroud. Oh, I have Spirit Shroud. This is a cloak of faces. Oh, it's a cloak. What kind of cloak do I have now? Oh, Spirit Shroud, duh. Two resistance. Is this worth it? To not have resistance? Keep the Spirit Shroud. I'm gonna keep the Spirit Shroud. I like the effect. I remember it going off. Heretic's Fork. Oh, this is what we already have this power. This is in case you don't have the power. Amplified and Cephalic Rush, we'll get that. And this, I'm guessing. Light range weapon, Ecstasy Paralyzer. Let's see this. Okay, see, she has a sting charge. Nice. 10 mental damage, plus 2 damage per effort applied to a max of plus 10. On hit, confers dazed, minus 15% willpower, and minus 15% on attacks. On critical hits, confer stunned. Character cannot move or take actions. Yeah, I think I'm sold for this. This will be great for Calistige. Awesome. Light range weapon. That works. Oh, and she's got a longer range, too. Her range is medium rather than short. Sold. Done. Oh, here's something else. 9 physical damage. 10. Yeah, I'd rather have this, actually. We have a neuropraxic detonation. Yeah. Have enough ciphers. We really need something freaking like, completely awesome in order to convince me to get another cipher right now. Bonded item artifact. 4 resistance plus 4 armor. Negative effects, minus 15% evasion, willpower, minus 8 initiative. That's okay. And I have a psychic focus. Plus 15% on lore, mystical tasks, and plus 2 damage on esoteric. Plus 2 damage for effort applied. Max plus 16 esoteric attacks. But we get minus 15% evasion and willpower. And minus 1 training level endurance. Do not like. Alright, so let's gather everything else. We have all the money. The money's not going to do us any good. But the items will. Okay. So, Fleetfoot Moss. Because I don't have the Fleetfoot Moss. Oh, he took that thing off me. I gotta re-equip that. Thought that looked familiar. Sorry, just rearranging here. Oh, I canceled it. Wait. Some speed. Intellect. Okay. That there. It made her, like, other selves more loud when I took that off. Okay, so this they need to re-equip. Wait, that's the infused crystalline shard. We don't even need that. So where's... Oh, there it is. Cool. Okay, so we can sell this. Sting charge. I'm gonna sell the crystalline shard as well. It's not really that great. Look at the thing, it's like burning there. Watch your hand. Okay, so he has all kinds of goodies. How much does Countess D's have? Let's see. It's just two regulars. So anyone can heal anybody when it's really needed. Okay, and now to Ioxu. Buy this crap. Buy that. And buy that. Done. This thing doesn't talk, right?
I'm ready.
Off to the Shrine of Chilla. Hope you guys didn't mind that. I mean, some people like to see, you know, what I'm buying and stuff and... Yeah, finding something to do. Maybe you guys feel the same way. Finally something to do.
Yes.
Get in there. Tell me yes. What if we find something else
All
here?
Right.
You've already acquired the mirror caster that was left by the changing god. Nothing else appears to be particularly valuable. Alright. Oh, there. You've been talking to the Memavera. She sent you to claim something from the heart, hasn't she? Or rather, someone. The old woman shakes her head, too frightened to go herself, for she knows what will happen if she does. And she thinks the cycle continues. Cycles within cycles. What will happen? Blue? Yeah. We have to know things. The bloom will eat her, body and soul. It doesn't matter how long she puts it off. The bloom will have her in the end. The only question is who it will find to take her place. She smiles. But you want to reach the heart, and I can help you.
Making a note.
One gets to the heart in the same way one gets anywhere in the bloom. A maw will take you, and the maw you want is just over there. The speck waves a hand toward the nearest corner of the shrine. You feel like a blindfold has been suddenly pulled from your eyes, and a wave of vertigo nearly knocks you to the floor. When you look up again, a maw has appeared. Really? What, like right there or something? There's my answer. Eyes sparkling, the speck reaches out a hand to steady you. Sometimes the bloom hides things from us. Its whispers distract our attention. Our senses perceive what's there, but our minds don't. Where does it lead? Duh, the heart of the bloom. Exactly where you want to go, to the heart, to the source of all the whispers. That maw has been here all along? So it has, but only my eyes could see. Even now, the others are blissfully unaware. She gestures at the cultists. There's only one up there. Some of them catch a glimpse now and then, but the whispers make them forget. What does it eat?
Making a note.
Predators. But only those who are feared above all others. A person. A creature. The maw doesn't care. Getting them into the maw, that's the hard part. Huh. Only the most feared of predators. She regards you with a critical eye. But you might suffice. Yeah. I met a man outside. He claims to be the former Memavera. So he was. A man who enjoyed holding lives at his mercy, pronouncing judgment from his throne. You hear the chittering, whispering voices of the bloom behind the speck's words, twisting their way into your mind. When you blink your eyes, the image of an imperious-looking man flashes before you. The same man you met outside, but younger, stronger, with a cruel curl to his lip. The one who walks without fear? The whole bloom was his palace, the seed of a kingdom he would build, for such was his ambition. And the bloom loved him for it. Such power it gave him. What sort of power? Every Memavera can open a maw at a touch, but not all can summon maws to their side. Fewer still can call them outside the fleshy walls of the bloom, as he could. But the bloom turned on him, just as it's turning on the Memavera now. Just as it always does. So many lives cut short by his hand, so much fear bound up with his name. He's grown fat with the terror and strife that he sowed. In the mind of the bloom, he was a beast made plump for the slaughter. The bloom eats terror and strife? It might. Or perhaps it devoured his legacy of terror and strife, rolling him around in its guts until he was forgotten, until he forgot himself. She shrugs. Who knows? The whispers don't say. Sounds like justice to me. Indigo tide, small amount. To you it might. To the bloom it's hunger. Nothing more. She thinks, is it justice if the bloom also goaded him to it? We'll never know, I suppose. We got experience from that. The speck slowly spins herself in a circle. It's all a cycle, round and round. Feast on one Memavera, raise another in his place. Let the hunger build. She stops. And feast again. How long has the bloom cycle been going on? Since the time of Chilla, at least. So, 4 centuries? 5? She seems momentarily confused. Before that, who knows? There was no speck to watch and remember. She thinks, certainly the bloom is much, much older than that. Likely the cycle is just as ancient. Since Chilla walked the bloom, maybe longer, but the whispers don't say. If Chilla was the first Memavera, wouldn't she have been part of the bloom's feeding cycle too? Blue tide. The speck turns to you sharply, eyes glittering. What are you saying? She thinks she is not the first to think she's discovered some great secret. Maybe. She's proof that the cycle can be beaten. A person can bond with the bloom and survive, if they're strong enough. Silver tide, small amount. She's silent for a long moment. A rare soul they need to be, but yes, maybe it could be done. She thinks, stronger than a bloom? Never. Or is that who Chilla truly was? So now the bloom wants to eat this Mamavera. That's why she's hiding in her tower. Too scared to leave her tower, too proud and stubborn to abandon the bloom, she's no different than the ones who preceded her. The bloom will eat her, and her name will be forgotten. Huh. I think I'll take a look at the maw. A thick mass of flesh protrudes from the walls, surrounded by waving tendrils. It appears to be another maw, just as the spec told you. Erita says, if this maw wants a predator, then it's found one. And by that I mean me. He turns to you. Will it eat me? Please let it eat me? Aren't you afraid of these things? He clears his throat. What I am is disgusted. Look at those things. What if they lick you? Who knows where those tongues have been? They remind me of sewage, and that's not something anyone should think about for too long. And, what Paragon and whatever inside him's like, we are hesitant about this. We are not. Why? You know why. But it might kill you. But it might not. Eritus pauses, seemingly unable to think of any arguments. Anyway, now that it's seen me, I'm sure it won't be satisfied with anyone else. So we can't just go in this one. We have to... Observe the behavior of the bloom tongues. You watch as the tendrils wave about, paying close attention to how they respond to those around you. Two or three of the tongues seem interesting callistees, stretching themselves in her direction. Some of her echoes observe the tongues with interest, while others seem fearful of them. A few tongues drift lazily towards Tybeer. He stares at them, muscles tense, like a man making eye contact with his executioner. When they drift away, he visibly relaxes. You soon realize, though, that the tendrils are especially interested in you. They stretch themselves toward you, as if awaiting your embrace. Even the whispers and chitters of the bloom sound inviting to your ears, tempting you closer to the maw. The tongues seem confused by Eritus. Some of them orient themselves toward him, their ends twitching furiously, while others pointedly avoid him. What should we do? The maw remains tightly shut. Light spills from the jagged seam that runs across its surface. Well, guys, yeah, I'm gonna leave it. Oh, there is two cultists. There's one here and one up there. I'm gonna leave it here. On a... kind of a... I don't know what you'd call that. Leaving on a cliffhanger, yeah. So next time we will offer something or do something to the maw. And we'll see a new area, I'm supposing. The Heart of the Bloom. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And enduring. Grow strong.